Today I will show you 7 different ways to speed up your WordPress website. But before we do that, first we have to know why you should speed up your WordPress website. Search engines like Google rank websites with faster loading times higher than the slower loading ones. Studies have shown that site loading speed of more than 2 seconds usually results in about 47% of the visitors bouncing off the website. And there are many more reasons to speed up your WordPress website this year. Now we have to know the loading time factors. The loading time of a website depends on these factors: the size of that particular page, how many requests it generates, whether it is cached or not, and lastly, what kind of content it hosts, either it is static or dynamic. The homepage of a website is usually used as a benchmark to test the loading time. In order to check the speed of a website, GT Metrics and Page Speed Insights are the most popular tools on the internet. Now, if you are thinking about how to test the loading time of your website, then here I have a WordPress website and I want to make this website faster. Now, before we start to speed up our WordPress website, let's check the current loading time of the website. Let's visit gtmetrics.com and here you have to enter your website URL and then click on test your site. And as you can see that these are the current loading time of our website showing on gtmetrics. And if you are a beginner, then 85% is not that bad. But I want to improve this performance, and for doing so, our task 1 will be WordPress optimization. It means deleting unwanted data from your database. It will minimize the size of your website and also helps in reducing the size of our backups. For optimizing our WordPress, what I will do is go to my WordPress dashboard. And from here, first of all, I will clean up my WordPress dashboard. Here you can see that my WordPress dashboard is kind of a mess. So that's why I will clean up my WordPress dashboard. First of all, I will click on this screen option. And from here, I will unselect every unnecessary options. That's it. Now close on screen option. And here you can see that I have now less options here. Now what I will do, I will close our these notifications. And now from here, I will go to our dashboard, and under our dashboard, here you can see that we have an updates option. And I will click on this updates. And inside our updates page, we can see all of our WordPress versions, our plugins and themes which are needed to be updated. First of all, I will update our WordPress version. So that's why I click on this update to version 6.0. And as you can see that I have successfully updated our WordPress version. And from here I will go to our dashboard and go to our updates once again. And here you can see that in our plugins, our all the plugins is up to date. But in our theme section we have to update our this theme. So that's why select all and then click on update themes. That's it guys, we have successfully updated our themes. Now if I go to our home, and from here you can see that we have another option, and it is saying that to update our WooCommerce database. So I will click on this update WooCommerce database, and as you can see that our WooCommerce database update is complete. Now dismiss this notification, and from here I will go to our post and all posts. And here I have all the posts. And from our this post list, I will delete all the drafted content. So that's why select this content which are drafted. And from here, select move to trash and then apply. After deleting our all the unnecessary contents, let's go to our appearance. And from here, click on the themes. And right now here you can see that I have activated these themes, but I also have two different themes here which are installed, but I don't need these themes. So what I will do, I will simply click on this theme And from here, click the delete button and click on OK. In the same way, I will click on this theme also, then delete, then OK. And right now here you can see that I have now only one theme. Then I will go to the left and then scroll down. And from here, I will go to our users. And from the user list, what I will do, I will delete all the fake accounts. So select all the fake accounts. And from here, select delete and apply. Then click on confirm deletion. That's it guys, we have successfully deleted all the fake accounts. Now removing all of this unwanted data from your WordPress will reduce the size of your database and web files. And this will definitely speed up your WordPress website. Next thing will be choosing a web hosting. For speed up a WordPress website, choosing a quality hosting provider is a major factor. And I prefer those hosting providers who provides cloud hosting for WordPress. And a cloud hosting is equal to best performance. Now I would like to introduce you to Cloudways, today's sponsor of this video. Cloudways is one of the few companies that offer a great balance between affordability and great functionality when it comes to cloud-based management WordPress hosting. Cloudways delivers fully managed hosting and promise no more slow loading WordPress sites and no more WordPress hosting headaches. Their platform as a service cloud server comes with some amazing feature set, and you can scale your hosting resources as your website grows. This company works with top 5 cloud providers such as DigitalOcean, Linode, Vulture, Amazon Web Service, and Google Cloud. These 5 provide the infrastructure, but you don't need to set up a direct account with them as Cloudways will set things up for you. Their infrastructure is optimized for service, performance, and security. As a managed hosting platform, Cloudways will help you to deploy your website in just a few clicks and with a few minutes. And the best thing about Cloudways is that they offer 3 days free trial to test their platform. You can host your website on their platform and monitor the performance of the website. To sign up with Cloudways for free, you can visit at www.cloudways.com. For speed up your WordPress website, use a lightweight WordPress theme. WordPress themes with a lot of dynamic elements, sliders, widgets, social icons, and many more shiny elements are amazingly appealing to the eye. But remember this, if you have too many elements and higher page sizes, then they will definitely cause your web server to take a lot of time to load up. The best option here is to use lightweight themes. One solution is to go for one of the default WordPress themes. And if you want other alternatives, then I will suggest you to go with Astra or Niv. Both are super fast and lightweight themes. Keeping unwanted plugins on your WordPress website will add a tremendous amount of junk to your website. Even if you are not using a certain plugin, there is a chance it is doing unnecessary work in the background and consuming a lot of resources. So for speed up your website, deactivate and uninstall those plugins which one you do not use. Let's go to our WordPress dashboard and scroll down. From here, we will go inside our plugins. And here you will see all the plugins which are now installed in our website. And from here, I will simply delete those plugins which I do not use. After selecting all the unnecessary plugins, from here, select deactivate and then apply. Then you have to select those plugins again. And from here, this time you have to select delete and then apply. Then click OK. Now one by one, all the unnecessary plugins will be uninstalled and deactivated from your WordPress website. That's it guys, we have successfully uninstalled all the unnecessary plugins. I hope you guys are enjoying this tutorial. If you find this video helpful, then please like this video, subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for the future updates like this. Now let's move on to another task. Now our next task will be install a WordPress caching plugin. Every time a visitor requests a web page from a non-cached site, the PHP of that WordPress server has to retrieve all the relevant content from the WordPress database, assemble it into an HTML file, and send that file to the client. This method takes more time and energy than sending a pre-written web page. A caching plugin simplifies this entire process. It builds every HTML page on a site with PHP, then saves these full HTML pages which are sent to the future visitors when they are requested. By skipping over all the building process, your website loads quickly on the browser. Now for installing a caching plugin on our WordPress, let's go to our WordPress dashboard. And from the plugins, we have to click on add new. And here we have to search for Lightspeed Cache. And here you can see that we have a plugin, and this plugin is developed by Lightspeed Technologies. Now we have to install this plugin, and then we have to activate this plugin. And if we go to the left and if I scroll down, here you can see that we have an option for Lightspeed Cache. Now let's go to our dashboard, and here you can see that we have our dashboard for Lightspeed Cache, and this plugin will speed up your WordPress website. Now after installing a caching plugin, our next step is optimize images. Images are the major contributors to the size increment of a given web page. The trick is to reduce the size of the images without compromising on the quality. You can manually optimize the images using some free online tools. Just go to your browser and search for png to webp tiny. And from here, open this first link. And from this website, you can manually optimize your images. You can reduce the image sizes without compromising the quality. For example, if I click on this upload file, and from here I will select an image and then click on open. And here you can see that the original size of this image is 905 KB, and after optimizing the image size, the final image file size is 58.35 KB. So here you can see that you guys can reduce the image sizes without compromising the image quality from this website, but it can take a lot of time to do it manually. Fortunately, from our caching plugin, we can do image optimization easily. So to do that, let's go to our WordPress dashboard, and from our Lightspeed Cache plugin, just click on image optimization. And from here, click on gather image data. By default, this plugin will automatically convert your all the images into web picture. But for the replacement of those web picture, instead of your original image, you have to go to your image optimization setting. And from here, if I scroll down, here you can see that we have an image web picture replacement, and we have to turn this on. And then we have to save the changes. And by doing that, all the images of your website will be converted into a web picture, and they will also reduce the original image size, and your website will be load faster inside a browser. If you add many images, multiple video embeds, and photo galleries to your blog post, then your site can be benefit from lazy loading. Instead of loading all your images and videos at once, lazy loading downloads only those that will be visible on the user's screen. It replaces all other images and video embeds with a placeholder image. As a user scrolls down, your website loads images that are now visible in the browser's viewing area. You can lazy load images, videos, and even WordPress comments and grab others. And for lazy loading, just go to our Lightspeed Cache, and from here go to our general, and from here we have to change some setting. First of all, we have to turn on this automatically upgrade and then save changes, then go to the left, and from here click on cache, and here you have to enable the cache, then go to our purge, And from here you have to turn on this option. Then go to our browser section. And from here you have to turn on this browser cache. Then save changes. That's it. And then from here go to our page optimization. And here you will find some options like CSS minify. And from here you have to turn on this CSS minify. Then save changes. Then you have to go to JS setting. And from here you have to turn on this JS minify. Then save changes. After that go to media settings. And from here you have to turn on these lazy loading images. Then scroll down and from here click on responsive placeholder and turn this on. Then scroll down. And from here you have to turn on these lazy load iframes. Then turn on this add missing sizes and click on save changes. After that let's go to our localization. And from here turn on this gravatar cache. Then save changes. After this one let's go to our light speed cache. And from here click on the toolbox. And from here we have to select this option purge all. That's it guys, here you can see that purge all the caches successfully. And after completing all the tasks, I have tested my website again in GTmetrix. And this time I have a performance of 99% and a structure of 85%. That's it guys, by following some tasks, you can speed up your WordPress website easily. And I hope you guys will find this tutorial helpful. And if you guys really do, then please subscribe this channel, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, please let me know in my comment section. And see you guys in our another tutorial.